state agencies and nonprofits trying to keep kids away from crime. Atlanta News First reporter Abby Casoras talks with people working with at-risk youth who say the only way to reverse the trend is more funding and resources.
Youth violence intervention groups and state agencies were called to the Capitol today. Lawmakers are looking to use their power to either allocate more money or pass legislation to address the issue of gun violence and criminal activity amongst youth. According to the U.S. Department of Juvenile Justice, people younger than 18 account for 1 in 14 arrests, most for robbery, some for murder or aggravated assault.
Last week, we had a holdup at our local jewelry store. It seems that criminals are emboldened. Is that kind of in line with what you're seeing?
If we know that this gang boss is in one of our prisons, why don't we do something about it?
These are the questions that state lawmakers had for these groups from Atlanta, Augusta, Columbus, and Savannah, trying to reverse the trend of increasing violence.
Keep them from becoming further involved with the criminal system in Richmond County.
Take Dr. Audrey Armistead with Children in Need of Services in Augusta. She's working with more than 1,200 kids to address youth violence. Thousands of kids in their county are not going to school. Hundreds are on probation. And 17 people under the age of 18 were murdered in Richmond County.
Come before a committee like this, we say we need resources so we can have these same kids in the building every single day to provide them the services that they need.
Counseling, after-school programs, and food donation, it all costs money. One of the drivers for crimes is Ken Howard with the Georgia Bureau of Investigation. He says gangs are recruiting children in most of the school systems in Georgia.
Local cops know who these kids are. We know who they are. And some of them would be good candidates for programs, but there's just not existing programs in some of these areas.
Urban Affairs Committee Chairman Representative Brian Prince says he doesn't plan on presenting any youth violence legislation this upcoming session, but several other members of his committee left that meeting saying this would be their priority. In Atlanta, I'm Abby Casoras.